I see people doing it in London, and I'm still looking at them like, this is insane. I mean, I see people waiting outside the thing. They're like 9 feet apart now, not even like 6 feet. And For me, I don't know, Doc, I have not bought into this fear. And it just looks ridiculous and seems ridiculous.
Okay, from a factual standpoint, from a science standpoint, it is ridiculous. From a scientific basis, there is no grounds for that at all. Because if it can travel 6 feet or 9 feet or 13 feet, it can travel 50 feet, 100 feet, and 1,000 feet. Ebola, tuberculosis, and smallpox, and that's it. Nothing else travels through the air. It's a total lie. And any person who comes out and says that, anybody, they are a liar. They have no scientific background. And if a scientist is saying it, they've already sold their soul to the devil and tracked their pockets back to see where the money's coming from. It is an absolute categorical lie. Second, and I mean, like I said, I've said I will go forward. And there are other doctors. I've got over 3,800 doctors that have joined our list just in the last 2 weeks saying that, you know, thank you. I can't even tell you how many doctors, literally hundreds of doctors, friends of mine that have sent me messages telling me that, thank you. I owe you my life. I owe you my profession. I owe you, you know, I'm praying for you. I'm keeping you in my thoughts. You know, I don't know where you get your courage from, blah, blah, blah. This has nothing to do with courage. It's simply because I want my kids to have a future, and they're not going to get a chip. And I will be the first person dead if those chips become mandated, because nobody's going to get chip me, and they're certainly not going to chip my kids. So when I'm gone from this planet, and again, I think I'm going to be here for a long time, and my hope is I'm going to be here for a long time, but that chip becomes mandatory, I will be dead, Brian. And I'm guaranteeing you right now, because nobody's going to put that chip in. That chip has it. That is, you know, some people talk about, I'm of the Muslim faith. In fact, I wish I could drink some water right now, but it's Ramadan, so I'm fasting. So it's hard for me, so my mouth is a little bit dry. But I'm telling you right now, in the Christian faith, they talk about the mark of the beast. I believe that might be the mark of the beast. Now, in fact, I know that's what it is. Now, my point, very simple, is the cycle. Now, let's look at the cycle, what's going to happen. You said they're going to prevent people from going to work unless they get the chip. And we're talking about the social distancing. They're imprinting the small amount of, in a small way, and it's going to get bigger and bigger about social distancing. There's technology that has been out for 15 years. Military has been using this technology. You can track a soldier. You've seen it in the movies, for God's sake. You can look at a soldier's movements 5 feet circumference around their moving. And if you look at when there's an operation that's taking place, a covert operation, the satellites can track soldiers, and they're always maintaining a certain amount of distance. Two reasons. One, which we know about, is because you step on a landmine or around, you know, that somebody identifies and they start shooting, it doesn't take out the whole unit. It doesn't take out the whole group of soldiers. It only takes out that one. So that's one reason they maintain distance. But the other reason is so that the satellites can pick up and see their movements, see what's going on. Now, is that possible? Absolutely it's possible, but it's even more sinister than that. How do we know that that chip that they're gonna put in, under the pretense of being able to recognize who's had the vaccine or not, which in itself is detrimental, but that chip is now allowing the satellites to pick up where we are, who we're congregating with, where we're moving to, how much money we have, what we're saying, what we're doing. Already, I mean, my son was saying, Dad, we're in New Zealand, and he says something about Dunkin' Donuts. There's no Dunkin' Donuts where we are, very remote. I pick up my phone, and my phone was there, his phone was there. I pick up my phone, and I said, where's that link that I sent you? It was a link on something funny. He picks up his phone, and there's an ad for Dunkin' Donuts. We'll be right back.